food preservation and methods of maximization of nutritional benefit. Food preservation is a name for a number of processes that help to preserve food. This means that the food treated that way will go bad and later that if it had not been treated the way. Food preservation is one of the oldest technology used by human being. Nutrition is critical for young children optimal growth and development. Now let us understand the meaning of food preservation. Food preservation is the process of treating and handling food to stop or slow down spoilage. Food preservation also include processes which inhibit natural discoloration that can occur during food preparation. Food preservation is the science of extending the shelf life of food while maintaining as much as possible of its nutritional quality and avoiding the growth of unwanted microorganisms. How to preserve food? Heating the food or baking it, that is, a hard corn flour biscuit stays edible much longer than a bowl of fresh corn. Converting the food into a longer lasting form, for example, fresh goat milk can be converted into a cheese which lasts much longer than fresh milk. Putting the food such as vegetable, meat or fish in salty water. Putting large amount of sugar in the food, for example, as with jam or fruit jar in sugar and water. Drying in the sun or in an oven. Smoking the food with the smoke from burning wood. Keeping the food cold or frozen. Now moving further, let us study what are the techniques of food preservation. Drying. Drying is one of the oldest techniques used to hamper the decomposition of food products. Vegetables and fruits are naturally dried by the sun and wind. Drying food is one of the oldest and easiest method of food preservation. Dehydrated foods are ideal for backpacking and camping because they weigh much less than their non-dried counterparts and do not require refrigeration. Drying food is also a way of preserving seasonal foods for later use. Refrigeration. Food refrigeration and freezing are the modern method of choice for preserving food. Most often refrigeration has positive result. The food keeps safe for long and nevertheless sometimes the unexpected happens. In refrigeration, food is stored between a temperature of 3 to 7 degrees Celsius, which are slightly higher than the sub-zero temperature of the freezer. Freezing. Freezing causes the water in the food to turn into ice, which is normally not the case with refrigeration. Therefore, frozen foods store longer, up to 6 months compared to a maximum of 7 days in a fridge, because freezing eliminates the free water available for bacterial growth, chemical and biochemical reaction. Cold stores provide large volume long-term storage for strategic food stock held in case of national emergency in many countries. Smoking. Smoking is one of the oldest methods of food preservation, probably having arisen shortly after the development of cooking with fire. There are different smoking methods of preserving food: cold smoking, hot smoking, barbecue smoking, wet and dry smoking. Smoking is the process of flavoring, cooking or preserving food by exposing it to smoke from burning or smoldering material, most often wood. Canning and bottling. It involves cooking food, sealing it in a sterilized can or jars, boiling the container to kill or weaken any remaining bacteria as a form of sterilization. Foods have varying degree of natural protection against spoilage and many require that the final step occur in a pressure cooker. Food preserved by canning and bottling is at immediate risk of spoilage once the can or bottle has been opened. After understanding the different techniques of food preservation, let us study the methods of maximization of nutritional benefit. Your body does not have the ability to turn garbage into a high quality product. All of your cells, muscles, skins, bones, etc. are built by the food that you supply. So, choose wisely. So, there are different methods to maximize nutritional benefit. Chop vegetables into a large chunks. When finely chopped vegetables will have more surfaces exposed to the air. which can zap vitamins and minerals. Put away peelers. When apples and cucumber are peeled, their antioxidant content decreases by 33% to 66%. Take a break after chopping veggies. After chopping green Brussels sprouts or cauliflowers, wait about 10 minutes before you cook or eat them. Some studies show that time enhances activation of certain nutrients in the vegetable. Let this stinky stuff breathe. Garlic, onion, and leeks can be quickly drained of many of their nutritional benefits when cooked. To maximize nutrient availability, slice up garlic, onion, and let them stand for about 10 minutes before further handling or cooking them, allowing time for some nutrients to be released. Let off some steam. Most veggies stand up well when given a good steaming. This quick cook method increases carrot antioxidant potential by nearly 300%, while cabbage get more than 400%. And be quick about that steam. The super nutritional power of some vegetables can be short-lived when cooked. That's why short cook times are crucial when preparing a mega vitamin-packed vegetables. Next, griddle your vegetables. Toast on a griddle, a flat metal pan with no cooking oil, vegetables may hold onto more of their antioxidant. Next method is zap your veggies in the microwave. Despite the microwave bad reputation, vegetables can maintain or even boost the antioxidant content of several types of vegetables, including carrots and spinach. Thank you.